Sweet Sadie Mae and Friends What Would You Do Stories. Copyright by Lee Holmes, 2023. Welcome to Sweet Sadie Mae's What Would You Do Stories series, Volume 1, where characters like Sweet Sadie Mae, her best friend Barkley, her dog Maggie, neighbor Heather, and the Ben and Bobby twins have fun, and sometimes get mad, but learn how to resolve disagreements. You can learn more about the Sweet Sadie Mae and Friends characters at the website sweetsadiemae.com and at the end of the story tracks. Before we start the stories, be sure to follow these three tips. Tip number one, be sure to listen carefully. At the end of the story, there will be a question about what you would do. Tip number two, be sure to use your imagination. While listening, pretend there's a mini movie playing in your mind and picture the characters and places in your head. Tip number three, be sure to stop and think. After each story, pause the story, think about your answer and share it with your parents, friends, or teacher. And remember, if you want, you can always replay the story to hear it again. The first story is about to begin. Hope you enjoy. These audio stories are licensed for single use by a family for personal listening only. Any use beyond this, including educational settings such as classrooms, districts, homeschool, group learning, or public performances, is prohibited without obtaining a separate educational license. If you're listening in a classroom, school, group educational setting, or public performance, please stop and go to sweetsadiemae.com/education to acquire a proper license for your organization. If you're listening in a personal family setting, please continue. Thank you, the stories will start now.
I Challenge You, Barkley, by Lee Holmes. Please be careful at the pool, Sweet Sadie Mae, and you too, Barkley, said Sweet Sadie Mae's mom as the two friends ran out the door.
I can't hear you, Mom. What did you say, shouted Sweet Sadie Mae?
I said, please be careful at the pool and follow all the rules.
Okay, we will, Mom, yelled Sweet Sadie Mae.
And be sure to listen to the lifeguards.
We will, Mom.
And they were off. Sweet Sadie Mae and Barkley ran through the neighborhood, past the baseball field, and into the Cedar Park pool.
Hey, look, Sweet Sadie Mae, it's Jimmy, said Barkley.
Oh, boy, said Sweet Sadie Mae.
Don't listen to him. If he tells you to do anything bad, you know how Jimmy is, Barkley.
Jimmy's not as bad as you think, Sweet Sadie Mae.
Watch this, Barkley, screamed Jimmy from the other side of the pool.
Barkley and Sweet Sadie Mae looked on as Jimmy ran across the deck and cannonballed into the pool.
Splash! No running, yelled the lifeguard as he blew the whistle at Jimmy.
Jimmy ran over to Barkley and Sweet Sadie Mae.
Bet you can't run and jump into the pool further than me, Barkley.
Yes, I can, said Barkley.
Sounds like a challenge, Barkley.
I challenge you. Show me you can do it.
Barkley started to stretch and warm up for his giant run into the pool. Sweet Sadie Mae grabbed his arm and gave him a warning look.
Barkley, do you remember what my mom said?
She said, be careful and listen to the lifeguard, Sweet Sadie Mae cautioned.
But she won't even know we didn't follow the rules, Sweet Sadie Mae. She's not even here, said Barkley.
If you were Barkley, what would you do? If you were Sweet Sadie Mae, what would you do? It's Not Easy Being Teased by Lee Holmes.
Sweet Sadie Mae, please go to the board and complete math problem number 3.
Yes, Miss Reddick, said Sweet Sadie Mae.
Eager to show she's good at math, Sweet Sadie Mae got up quickly from her desk and walked to the chalkboard to complete the problem. Next, she heard the whispers from some of her classmates in the first row.
Look at her weird hair, they sneered. Why does she wear it like that?
Her hair looks stupid.
Sweet Sadie Mae started to get upset.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.